ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، اللهم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم، ولا فهم لنا إلا ما فهمتنا إنك أنت الجواد الكريم. اللهم إنا نسألك الثبات والهداية ونعوذ بك من الخذلان والغواية. آمين يا رب العالمين. وبعد، My respected brother and sister Islam, yesterday was the day of Thanksgiving in America, in Canada. And this weekend, the whole weekend they celebrate as Thanksgiving weekend, Thanksgiving Thursday, Black Friday. And in these days, they thank and appreciate those who gave him favor. And today, inshallah, I will talk and discuss the concept of thanksgiving or appreciation in Islam. Does Islam allow us to give thanks and to appreciate? So my dear respected brothers and sisters Islam, I would like to start with the beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, reported by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ash-shukru nisful iman." The shukr, you can translate shukr as appreciation or thanksgiving or thankfulness. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this shukr is not a part of our iman, is not a part of our Islam, but in fact it is the half iman or half Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al haya is shu'batun min al iman. That haya, shame, modesty, is a part of iman. Al taharatu shatr al iman. The tahara, cleanliness, is a part of our iman. But when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned about the shukr, he said that this is the half of our iman, half of our Islam. If you look at the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the famous name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ash-Shakur. Ash-Shakur, the one who accepts the gratitude and appreciation. He says in the Holy Quran, بَعْدَ الْأَقُولَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor and shakoor. So my dear respected brothers in Islam, the ignorance from this quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shukr in reality, is the ignorance from Allah's names, from the qualities of Islam and Iman. And if someone wants to be a true and complete mu'min, he has to have this quality of shukr, appreciation, thankfulness, gratitude. And my respected brothers in Islam, we translate thankfulness or gratitude in Arabic or in even Urdu as shukr. So what is the literal meaning of shukr. We always like in Urdu, we say like when we like in our English we say thank you. In Urdu we say shukriya, which is from shukr. In Arabic we say shukran, which is also from shukr. So what is the meaning, literal meaning of shukr in Arabic? The literal meaning of shukr in Arabic is to appreciate a person and also to praise him. First you acknowledge and then you praise him. This is the literal meaning of shukr. And the shar'i meaning or istilahi meaning of shukr in Arabic is تعظيم المنعم لكونه منعما. To honor the producer of the favor because he produced you the favor. And how do you thank and appreciate him? سواء كان باللسان by your tongue. Whether you appreciate him by your tongue, by saying thank you, shukriya, shukran, jazakallahu khairan, أو بالجنان, or you thank him by your heart, by admiring, by acknowledging his favor, أو بالأركان, or by other parts of your body, by shaking hand, by giving him a big hug. That's how you must thank a person. And my respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our utmost thanks and appreciation should go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First and foremost, shukr is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discussed the conversation between him and shaitan when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kicked him out from the Jannah. So he got mad and he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of these people inside, I am kicked out from the Jannah. He says, ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ. Then, because of these people, I am kicked out from the Jannah. I will misguide them. And I will come to them from their front, from their back, from their right, from their left. And then he said, وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. This is the trick of shaitan. وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. Oh Allah, you won't find most of them to be grateful to you. And most of the people, when they achieve something in their life, they admire their efforts, their parents, their teachers, but they forget that everything we achieve in our lives is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's only and solely from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So most of the people are ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِ يَشَّكُرُونَ. Very few of my servants are grateful to me. Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the virtue of gratefulness in the Holy Quran, إِسْتَأَذَّذَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِ لَشَدِيدٌ. That if you are ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase His ni'mas, His blessings, His favors upon you. وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ. But if you are ungrateful, then you should remember, إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shadeed. So our utmost thanks, appreciation, should go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then my respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the second thanks should go to people. Anyone and everyone who gives us a favor, we must thank him. It is our duty, responsibility. It is not like something like you should do or you have twice, you have to. In fact, in one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and this hadith is reported in Shu'ab al-Iman by Nu'man bin Bashir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ النَّاسِ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ اللَّهِ. Who does not thank people, in reality, he does not thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you want to be a shakir, a grateful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first you have to thank people. If they give you something, if they help you in anyhow, you have to say thank you, jazakallahu khairan, shukran, shukri, anyhow you have to appreciate. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ashkaru nasi lillahi, ashkaruhum linnas. The most thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those who are most thankful to people. And you will find very few people. If they have this quality of sugar, whatever you give them, if you pick up a pencil for them, if you open door for them, they say shukriya, thank you, jazakallah. This is the quality of iman. This is not the quality. This is one of the qualities they adopted from us. And they have a day, Thanksgiving day. But Islam teaches us not only in this time, not only one day in the year we have to thank, but on the daily basis we have to appreciate and acknowledge those who give us a favor. And how should we thank and appreciate? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. The reward of ihsan is nothing but the ihsan. Very famous ayah of Surah Al-Rahman. هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. If someone does ihsan to you, you must do ihsan to him. And how you do ihsan to him? Number one, you pay back whatever he gives you, like if he gives you a gift, same gift or maybe better gift, exchange with him. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ أَتَى إِلَيْكُمْ مَعْرُوفًا فَكَافِئُوهُ. If someone does ihsan for you, you must pay back ihsan to him. This is number one. Number two, فَإِن لَمْ تَجِدُوا فَدْعُوا لَهُ. If you don't find anything to pay back, then at least give him a dua. Give him a dua. And my respected brothers and sisters, it is very important if we are in our house, in Muslim gathering, and when it's time to thank and appreciate, instead of saying thank you, shukriya or shukran, we have to give a dua. Because you know, thank you, by thank you are not giving him anything. Thank you, shukriya or shukran. You are not giving him something that he can benefit from. So the Prophet ﷺ taught us a hadith, a dua. If you read, if you say this dua, if you are not paying him something back in this world, but inshallah, by this dua, they will gain something in the akhirah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us a dua in Tirmidhi, مَنْ صُنِعَ إِلَيْهِ مَعْرُوفًا. Whoever is given a favor, and then in the return he said, جَزَاكَ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. This is the dua that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. جَزَاكَ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. جَزَاكَ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. Very simple, very easy dua. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever says jazakallahu khairan in the return of a favor, فَقَدْ أَفْلَغَ السَّنَا. So indeed, he exceeded in his praising, and he paid back his favor. So say jazakallahu khairan, and the correct pronunciation is jazakallahu khairan. Number one, use the full dua, jazakallahu khairan. Most of the time, when we are texting, we just say Jazakallah. May Allah give you back something. But you don't say like, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a good thing or bad thing. So that's why my teaching is to say Jazakallahu khayran, full dua. May Allah reward you in the best manner. Jazakallahu khayran. This is number one. And number two, the correct pronunciation is Jazakallahu khayran or Jazakallahu khayra. Majority of time we say Jazakallahu khayr. This is a grammar mistake in Arabic. Jazakallahu khayran. That's the correct pronunciation. Although it does not make change the meaning, but the correct pronunciation is Jazakallahu khayran. That's how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us the dua. And my respected brothers and sisters, now when it's time to thank people and appreciate, our first and foremost thing should go to our parents and people, because they are the ones who give us the most favor after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded us again and again in the Holy Quran, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا. He advised us to do ihsan to our parents. وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حُسْنًا. Do good to them. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah decided that none should be worshipped except Allah, and that you do ihsan to them. قُلْ تَعَالَوْا أَتْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Do not do shirk with anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that we do ihsan to your parents. And then my respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our second thanks should go to our spouses, our husbands who take care of our expenses, and also our wives. So time to time, thank them. Like when we go in a party, it is the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make the dua, Allahumma at'im man at'amani wasqi man saqani. Oh Allah, you feed those who fed us and give drink to those who give us a drink. And on the daily basis, we eat from the hands of our parents, from the hands of our mothers, and our wives. So on the daily basis, whenever we eat, we must give them this dua. On the daily, this is the dua. When you eat from someone's house or from someone's cooking, you have to give them this dua. So this dua, we should say like when we eat from something our moms cooks for us or our wives. Allahumma at'im man at'amani wasqi man saqani. And last but not least, my respected brothers and sisters in Islam, it is very important to appreciate and thanks to those who give us a favor. And also those who do not give us a favor from our relatives, still we have to be good with them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the famous hadith, Musnad Imam Ahmad rahimahullah reported this hadith by Uqba bin Amir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, Ya Rasulullah, akhbirni bi fawadil al-a'mal. O Prophet of Allah, inform me about the best things in Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sil man qata'a. Sil man qata'a. Who is bad with you, who cut a relationship with you, you join a relationship with him. Wa a'ti man haramat. And who does not give you, you be nice with him and give him something. وَعْفُ عَمَّنْ ظَلَمَكْ. And who is wrong with you, you forgive. So this is the quality of Islam and Iman. Be nice and kind to those who are not good with you. What about those who are nice and good with you? Make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to appreciate Him and those who give us favors and those who support us in our lives, from our parents, spouses, brothers, sisters, children, and all other relatives and friends. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them all jazakumullahu khairan, the best reward in this dunya as well as in the hereafter. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite us all in جنة الفردوس آمين يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. شرف الإسلام.